All right, let's see how this works in Microsoft Project. I've just opened a new project that will show you the behavior of fixed duration tasks. Notice that I have two tasks. One is called Q4 Customer Support. It currently has a fixed duration of 63 days. It starts on October the 1st and it ends on December 31st. Basically, I'm trying to capture how much customer support we're doing during the last quarter of the year. So I don't want my finish date or duration to change. So in an attempt to do that, I'm going to use the fixed duration task type. Now, in this scenario, what I'm going to simulate is what happens if you're using Microsoft Project Server and your team member is entering progress in the timesheet page of Project Web App. Notice already in the bottom pane here, in the task usage pane, Cindy McNair has already reported her progress for the first couple days of the task, as has David Baker. But Gary Howard has just submitted his progress. He was supposed to start on Thursday, but he didn't actually get started until Friday because of other interruptions. He did know customer support until Friday. So when Gary enters 2 hours of actual work on Friday, and then I accept the updates into my Microsoft Project schedule, this is what will happen. Microsoft Project will warn me that the duration of this fixed duration task is about to change. When I click OK, ladies and gentlemen, there you see it with your own eyes. Look, the duration is now 64 days. The finish date has now slipped into 2016. Why? Why did this happen? Here's what I want you to understand. When a resource starts late on a task to which multiple resources are assigned, Microsoft Project will always delay the remaining work for the late starting resource by the number of days of their late start. So for example, in our case, Gary Howard started 1 day late. Therefore, all of his remaining work will be pushed to the right 1 day further. All right, let's continue. Let me close the task usage pane. And now I want to go to the resource sheet view. Cindy McNair has submitted some vacation. So I need to go into the resource information dialog and I want to enter her planned vacation. Now, she's going to be taking vacation in November, so let me go ahead and scroll to November. She has 2 company holidays already for Thanksgiving Day and the Friday after Thanksgiving, or Black Friday. So she's going to be smart and get a week of vacation by just taking 3 days off for paid time off or PTO. So let me go ahead and I'll just type in vacation for Cindy. That'll block that off as non-working time. And then I'll click OK. Oh, look at there. There's that warning again. The duration of that task is changing and the finish date as well because of the vacation. Now let me jump to the task usage view directly. And I'll be able to show you what's actually going on here. If I scroll out to the end of December, I can actually show you. Look, here is December 31st. It's on a Thursday. David Baker, he's still finishing on Thursday. Gary Howard started 1 day late. Therefore, his finish date is now Friday, January the 1st. Cindy McNair is taking 3 days of vacation. That forces her remaining work to be delayed by those 3 days. Look, they're actually pushing out into the week of January the 3rd. All right, now there's more. I want you to know that in scenarios like this, if you are using fixed duration tasks to try to lock a duration window for a purpose such as this, generally what I recommend is that you simply ignore the duration changes and the finish date changes until the last week of the task, at which point you can change the finish date back to what it was supposed to be and get your progress in for that final week. This is a losing battle, I want you to know, so please don't try to fight it. Now let me go back to the first week of the project. This is the week of October the 4th. Let me keep scrolling here. Here we go. Actually, it's the second week of the project. And Marsha Bickle is now reporting some progress on her project server timesheet page. And this is what Marsha reported. She reported that she did 8 hours on Monday and 8 hours on Tuesday doing on-site consulting with the client. But then Marsha did this, and I'll drag the split bar over so you can see the remaining work column. On the first day of work, the client told Marsha, "Hey, we really like your work. We want to run through a change control order and have you stay an extra day or two." So they ran the change control order through our company, EPMA, which is the way it would happen in the real world. Turns out Marsha didn't need to be anywhere. So here's what Marsha did. She changed the remaining work to 8 hours on this task in her timesheet. And when I accept her update, here's what happens, kids. Look at that. The same warning. Microsoft Project is going to change the duration. Look, the duration changed and the finish date changed as well. So then here's what happened. Marsha went ahead and entered 8 hours of work for that day. And then the client decided to extend it one more day before they let her go home. So they ran through the change control order with EPMA, and on her timesheet, Marsha Bickle reported she also worked 8 hours on Friday, or on Thursday, excuse me. So again, when I enter 8 hours, it's past the current finish date of the task, which is Wednesday. So when I put 8 hours on Thursday, again, there is the warning, the duration of the task is changing, and the finish date is changing as well. So ladies and gentlemen, you can clearly see in this demonstration that on a fixed duration task, there are scenarios that can force the duration of the task to change and the finish date of the task to change as well.